My name is Lisa Diamond. I'm a professor of psychology and gender studies at the University of Utah in Salt Lake City. And I'm a developmental psychologist, and I've been studying the sort of development and expression of same-sex sexuality over the life course. And so the perspective that I've tried to bring to this conference and in my own work really has to do with the diversity of same-sex sexuality. I think historically, people who have done sort of research on women and clinical approaches to women and their health have sort of divided sexual orientation into some pretty rigid categories, that you've got the lesbian population and you've got the heterosexual population. And, you know, and so diversity just basically means including both groups instead of just one. But what we now know is that the population of women with same-sex attractions is actually pretty broad and much more diverse than we used to think. The vast majority of women with same-sex attractions actually have bisexual patterns of attraction rather than exclusively same-sex attractions. Some of them identify as lesbian, some of them identify as bisexual, some of them identify as heterosexual. And so the kinds of women that a practitioner might have in their practice, it might not be immediately apparent, and that their past pattern of attraction and their past pattern of behavior doesn't necessarily tell you how they identify themselves, what their current attractions are, what relationships they are currently in or plan to be in the future, and that we really need a sort of more open-ended and more inclusive approach to assessing women's sexual attractions and behaviors in order to capture all that variation. The other thing that I think is really important to note is the prevalence of change over time in sexual attractions. We now have a broader appreciation for something called sexual fluidity, which is this capacity for individual sexuality to undergo some fluctuation over time. It doesn't mean that there's no such thing as sexual orientation or that people don't have an orientation. It just means that whatever orientation, whatever general predisposition you have, is not deterministic, and there's some wiggle room, there's some flexibility around it. In the longitudinal research that I've done, I found some sort of pretty heterosexual women who have a one-time only relationship with a woman, and some lesbian women who have a one-time only relationship with a man, and those experiences are normative, and they can happen at any point in the life course, and it's something for practitioners to sort of be aware of, to be accepting about, and to communicate an inclusive attitude about.